On this side, remove the two screws. Make attention not to damage the developer roller. The developer roller transfer the toner from the cartridge to the drum. This is the second screw. Remove the cover plate and the reset gear. This is the reset gear. Please note the position of the gears. Remove the three gear you see in the video. Remove the black plastic spacer from the developer roller shaft. It has a hook. You have to press it to release it. Remove the reset gear spring. On the gear side, press an unlocking tag and rotate the developer roller lockup. Remove the last gear. Remove the developer roller, sliding it from its bushing. Remove the fill plug from the cartridge. Dump the remaining toner and blow out the cartridge. It's important to clean the cartridge as well as possible, better using compressed air. The old toner may cause quality problems. Carefully wipe the doctor blade. Be careful not to bend or damage the blade in any way. Also, inspect the developer roller felts. If compressed, rough them up with a small screwdriver. Gently clean the developer roller with isopropyl alcohol. Reinstall the developer roller. Turn the lock towards the doctor blade until it locks in place. Install the gears in the order shown. Make sure all the gears are meshing properly. Reinstall the black piece of plastic. Set the reset spring as shown. Ensure the actuator gear is in the following position. Set the reset gear as shown. The reset gear is spring loaded. It must be positioned correctly for the printer to accept the remanufactured cartridge. Install the gear cover plate. There are three types of cartridges. The starter cartridge has no reset gear and can't be remanufactured. This is the low yield cartridge. The reset gear has three flex. This is the high yield cartridge. Make sure the black arrow on the cover is aligned with the white arrow on the reset gear. Reinstall the two screws. Fill the cartridge with the toner. The high yield cartridge contains 90 grams of toner. Reinstall the fill plug. The work is done. Make some test pages, pressing the Go button three times.